everybody. I'll go ahead and save your fingers the typing and let you know that no, I was not a Boy Scout. Huh. Do you wish that I had Boy Scouty skills? Being able to like tell directions. Oh, I wish I could start a fire. A campfire, not burn buildings down. Really just those two things. I would have been a pretty ambitious Boy Scout. Last week's Ask Kristen, I solicited y'all's advice on how to make long distance relationships work. Abby Parfait says, the main piece of advice I can offer to them, be together in person as often as possible. People can be totally different online than offline. Sometimes they're better and sometimes they're worse. Just make sure they know the true person in each other. Excellent advice, Abby Parfait. Honey Leah says, I've been with my fiance for almost 7 years. The last two have been spent long distance, and it was so hard at first to be in an LDR, but it got easier with time, and adjustment took about 4 months. We lived together for 3 years before, so that's why I think it was so difficult. You are so right about having a light at the end of the tunnel. We've been looking forward to being together again, and that's what's kept us going. In only 2.5 months, we'll be living together yet again. Thanks, honey Leah, and congratulations. Zed Matos says, currently in a long distance relationship, had our 4th anniversary just last week. I met her on a gaming forum and we both fell in love after about a year of being friends. We make it work by being extremely honest with each other. If we tell each other exactly what we want, need out of each other, exactly when we need it without assuming that the other is a mind reader, that's important, we'll be able to make it through this. 4 years and counting, but we can see the light at the end of the tunnel. Congratulations, Sid! If I am mispronouncing your name, the internet said that that's how it's pronounced, so blame the internet. Thanks to everybody else who commented on that video as well and shared your long distance relationship stories, some happy, some not. On to this week's Ask Kristen question from Liz Grace. Liz wants to know a question that I had no idea. So perplexes the internet. I'm interested in your theories on the eternal debate. Does giving birth hurt more than being kicked in the balls? I believe these are two very different experiences that should not be compared to one another, but this debate keeps popping up everywhere. I think it's time we settled this once and for all. Many of you probably know ASAP Science has done a video on this in which they declared it a tie. More like WTF Science. The reason though that they declared it a tie is because pain is subjective. What hurts to me might not necessarily hurt to you. They went on to talk about how testicles are essentially just riddled with these things called nociceptors, our pain receptors. They signal to our brain, whoa, something is going wrong with the body. Those nociceptors are connected to the stomach and the brain's vomit center. For that reason, getting kicked in the balls can hurt really bad. So bad, in fact, ASAP Science contends that it could possibly, theoretically, hurt as much, if not more, than giving birth to a child. I mean, you'd really have to wallop those balls. There's no actual scientific way to determine, yes, childbirth is more painful, or yes, getting kicked in the testicles is really more painful. But I do have one major bone to pick with that ASAP Science video. In their conclusion, they say that really the only main difference between giving birth and getting kicked in the testicles is that when you give birth, a baby comes out. Hey, whoa. Chances are when you get kicked in the balls, your penis does not rip open. When you give birth, unless it is via cesarean section, your vagina rips open. You ever see a dilated vagina? So if only for that, in addition to extended labor pains, it's gotta be childbirth. But I also want to acknowledge my own subjectivity in this situation. As a woman, I have no testicles and therefore can never experience the pain of getting bonked in the balls. I decided to pull Professor Boyfriend, who has in fact been bonked in the balls. He gave me a look like this. He was like, childbirth. So Liz Grace, I am sorry to inform you that until science develops some kind of empirical unit for pain, this question is probably gonna continue coming up. From what I hear, childbirth, super painful. From what I hear, getting kicked in the testicles, super painful. Which one is more? Science can't actually tell us conclusively. It is science's fault that we are stuck debating this totally pointless question. And unfortunately, now I can only solicit even more subjectivity. What do you think? Which is more painful? Childbirth, getting kicked in the balls. Really, I just wanna know how many people out there think that getting kicked in the testicles is more painful than having a baby. Be sure to ask me your questions for next week as well. As proven by this video, I will answer anything. Even if it deals with testicles. I ain't scared.